my friends. So we're going to learn about Hokusai. And he was the artist who is from Japan, and he made this beautiful painting that was a woodblock printed art at first that was the Great Wave. So we are going to make our very own Great Wave. All right. So today we're just going to start off drawing a wave and then having something out in the distance from it. So our wave, because it's great, right? It should be big, and you can make it really curly and curvy. I really like to add lots of like wavy kind of features in here to make it really exciting. You can even add waving lines. Now let's think about something that's gonna go over here. It can be a mountain, it can be a volcano, anything like that. I really like the volcano idea. So I am just gonna kind of draw like this little mountain area and then have a little volcano out in the distance. And if you want your volcano to be erupting, sure, we can even add some more color with that. And I think that would be really pretty to see. So that's what we're all going to be doing today. You're just drawing me your wave with something in the background. It can be a little island, it can be your volcano, anything like that. And I'm excited to see what you make. Bye, my friends. All right, friends, so this is when we're going to start using our watercolors. If you don't have watercolors at home, that's okay. But remember, with all watercolors, we got to put a lot of water in and make it even like a pool. And then with our cup, remember, we are not using it to drink out of. It is just our cup. Now, the Great Wave is probably gonna be very blue, right? So I'm gonna be using a lot of blue paint, right? But I also have to think about what I'm gonna be using for the background. Is the sky gonna be blue as well? Or is it gonna be a sunset, right? And remember, with watercolors, right, you're gonna probably want a day to dry in between your wave and then your background, right? Because we don't want any of the colors bleeding into each other, right? Now, one thing I can even do here is I can add more colors into my water, right? So if I don't want it to just be blue, what if I add some purple, right? Or some green, right? That way I can make my water be a lot more colorful, especially since it's the main part of our art. Now remember, Hokusai, when he made that, he did a lot of whites, right? And the white was making it look like it was really cold, right? So the purple with this blue kind of makes it more cold. Well, if we made it green, it would probably look more like tropical, right? So all I'm gonna do is I'm gonna focus on my wave. And after I'm done focusing on my wave, I can even think about my volcano. So I'm going to take out all of the paint in my cup here, really making sure. And then I'm going to start working on my island here. So I'm going to make sure I got some water from that, and I'm gonna start making my volcano. Woo. And our volcano, really make sure that it has lots of fun color. And since we made it erupting, and maybe some of you guys made it erupting too, I can add some red into that, and that way it kind of can make the painting more colorful, right? And I'm really excited to see how this is going to look. I think you guys will really like it if you make yours erupting. So that's it for today. I just want you to focus on the foreground, which is just, remember, your beautiful wave and then your island, right? So that's it for today. Just focus on your wave and your island. Don't think about the background yet, okay? And I hope to see you all soon. Bye, my friends. We're just gonna pretend that my wave is done here, and we're gonna start working on our background. Now, the background can be blue if it's like a sky. It can be black, like it's nighttime. But I think that I wanted to make it like a sunset, so I'm gonna make it yellow. And that way, my background kind of doesn't blend in together. Now, I made the mistake of making it blue before, and look what happened, my friends. My colors got all muddied up, and they look really similar to each other. And so I want to really make sure that my colors don't get all muddied up. And a great way to do that is waiting a day to color in between, especially if you're using your watercolors, all right? And that's all for today. You are just working on your background and finishing up your painting. Remember, for this, we're still trying to have craftsmanship. I still want you guys to make sure that there's no white spots in here at all, right? And really take your time, okay? And I'm excited to see how your waves look. And I hope you all are doing well. Bye, my friends.